Saltworks, February 2017. What we have here is FGD wastewater concentrated up in the Salt Splitter-RO to about 95% recovery. That means these brines represent about 5% in total of the total treatment flow. So, we've got Anissa, help me out here. Which one's this? This is a calcium chloride rich brine. This is a sodium sulfate rich brine. We're going to combine the brines and we'll show you what happens. Anissa. This is the first time we've done this. No party tricks. It's just at least first time we've done this with FGD water. All right, it's becoming cloudy. Feel free to zoom in, Jen. It's becoming cloudy. That means something is forming. The laws of chemistry hold. Calcium chloride, sodium sulfate. Calcium sulfate forms. Calcium chloride brine, TDS, is approximately 200 odd thousand, Anissa, yeah. Of which I think 60 odd percent is calcium, magnesium. The sodium sulfate brine is what approximate TDS, Anissa? Pardon me?
10%.
10%, 100 odd plus thousand. Now it's become super cloudy. You can start to see, at least in, I know the camera's not as good, you can start to see a stratification here. Darker, lighter. Stratification is moving down. We've got a timer going. Definitely changing in physical appearance. You may not be able to see it on the camera, but it's starting to look thicker on the bottom, almost like a liquefied plaster of Paris, if you will. Let's see what looks there. So here's some solids. See, our objective here is to, it's always beneficial in a ZLD system to remove as much solid mass as you possibly can at the lowest possible cost, which in our case, this brine, these two brines that we generated are from a membrane system. So just a combination of reverse osmosis and EDR tweaked, which are the two most popular desalination technologies in the world. Now we combine the two brines and you can look, although this is a fluffy liquid solid mass, almost 85% of the beaker is a liquefied solid. You can also look at the top layer. You may not be able to see it as well on the camera, but it's clarified actually really nicely. So I'm going to get a scoop from deeper down. Look at all, I'm actually shocked at the volume of the solids and how quickly it clarified. In all honesty, this is the first time we've done this with FGD. I wonder what will happen on the fifth time after we've optimized it. Stay tuned.